Hello, Lakers Nation. It's game day. Lakers versus Bulls tonight. Can the Lakers keep their unbeaten road streak alive? I'm Trevor Lane for LakersNation.com. Make sure you subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Don't forget to come join us on the Flick app. I'm going to be chatting live there during the game so we can go back and forth, talk about what we see happening in Lakers versus Bulls. All you got to do is use the link in the description down below. And don't forget to put in your Flick picks where you make predictions for tonight's game and you can win cash. All right, so Lakers versus Bulls, this is actually the second time that they're going to see the Bulls in just over 2 weeks. And I think the Lakers are actually going to approach this game with a little bit of fire. I don't think they walked away from their last meeting with the Bulls feeling that good, even though it was a Lakers win. They only won by 2 points. Now, we do have to note that Anthony Davis didn't play in that game. And, well, you know, he tends to make a little bit of a difference. But last time around, Zach LaVine blew up on the Lakers for 38 points. That was a rough one. So I'd like to see the Lakers approach this game locked in and take care of business to push that road streak to 9-0. By the way, guys, don't forget, right after the game, as soon as the final buzzer sounds, we go live right here on YouTube. You can come join the Lakers Nation live post-game show. We break down the whole game. We take your questions and comments. It's a ton of fun. So come join us here right after the game. All right, so what do the Lakers need to do in order to get this win? Well, first of all, yeah, you got to slow down Zach LaVine. Giving up 38 points to him is not going to fly. But the Bulls last time around also performed extremely well in a number of categories that they typically don't. For example, points in the paint. They put up 62 points on the Lakers in the paint last time around. Again, no Anthony Davis, which certainly makes a difference there. But that has been a topic of discussion around the Lakers recently. They've slipped all the way to 21st in the NBA in opponents' points in the paint. It has been something that Frank Vogel has been focusing on in his film sessions. So can the Lakers clean that up and keep the Bulls from dropping that many points on them in the paint? That is going to be really key. Plus, I'd like to see the Lakers force more live ball turnovers. Chicago, they play at the second fastest pace in the NBA. They like to turn games into a track meet, and the Lakers are going to have to control that a little bit. But because they play at such a fast pace, they're also very, very sloppy with the ball. They turn it over a ton. In fact, they're 29th, next to last in the NBA in turnover percentage. So that should provide the Lakers some opportunities to get out in transition if they can force some live ball turnovers. But last time they played the Bulls, Chicago only had 12 turnovers. That was their lowest mark of the entire season. Again, the Bulls probably, even though they lost, probably played their best game of the season last time they played the Lakers. So if they can force more turnovers, they can turn this game very quickly into what I could see being an in-game load management situation. If you know what I'm talking about, I'm saying a game where the Lakers get out to a big lead and head into the fourth quarter, and they just tell LeBron James and Anthony Davis, hey, we've got this. You guys, you play your 25 minutes tonight and then go take a rest over there on the bench. LeBron, put on your flip-flops and we'll rest you up for next game. That could be in play here. This Chicago Bulls team is not good. They're 22nd in the NBA in net rating, 10th in offensive rating, so their offense isn't bad, but 27th in defensive rating. So again, if the Lakers come out locked in, which they don't always do, sometimes they play down to their competition, but so far they've been pretty locked in on the road. If they can continue that, I think this is a game that they could put away nice and early. But again, the Bulls have Zach LaVine. They've got some serious scoring punch there. And if the Lakers aren't sharp defensively, they could be in for a fight as well. We're going to have to wait and see exactly how this one plays out. But don't forget, come join us right after the game on the Lakers Nation live show and join me on the Flick app during the game. I'll be chatting live there. And don't forget to put in those Flick picks. If you guys want to follow Lakers Nation across social media, you can find us at Lakers Nation on Twitter and Facebook, at Lakers Nation Official on Instagram. If you want to follow me, you can find me at Trevor_Lane on Twitter, at Trevor Lane NBA on Facebook and Instagram. We'll see you after the game.